Again, market reforms specifically I have asked. Market reforms. Now you have to write market reforms means what is the purpose, what is market reforms, what is the impact. These three things I need to have. When I'm asking a specific question, what we have to do? First, we have to write what it is, why it is, how it was implemented, what is the impact of it. What it is market reforms? Alauddin Khalji wanted to establish markets where the prices of each and every commodity could be fixed by the state. Finished. Market reforms. Accordingly, he established three types of markets. Grain market, luxury market, slave market. What is this market reforms? For fixing the price of the commodities, he established this market reforms. How he did it? Three markets he established. Next, we have to think why these market reforms are needed. Because Alauddin Khalji was concerned that the welfare of the people is primary. Some historians say this. The people should get more by less money. Why, sir? Maximum tax is collected by the state. The people are left with bare minimum. You understand? So people should feel fulfilled by this bare minimum. Secondly, soldiers are paid a low salary. Soldiers. Why are they paid a low salary? Because you have increased the number of troops. So it should not be a burden on the state treasury. So he paid low salary. But the soldiers also should be satisfied with their low salary of 234 tanka per year. 234 tanka per year was the salary paid by the Alauddin Khalji by two soldiers. 234 tanka. Okay? Low salary. So this is the reason why. Sir, how it was implemented, sir? Alauddin Khalji implemented it by two ways. One, ensuring adequate buffer. Number two, monopolizing. The state monopolizing all the trade with outside. Outside the country. All the buffer stocks were ensured by collecting land revenue. 50% of the land revenue in the Dob region was collected in grains. Alauddin Khalji, eppadi vaangna? Land revenue, 50% of the producer. And the land revenue, 50% grains are vaangra, Alauddin Khalji. And he employed Banjaras and placed all this in the godowns in Delhi. Employed Banjaras and stored all this in the godowns of Delhi. Banjaras, grain merchants. Secondly, what if the commodity is not being produced in India? For example, luxury commodity, like some cloth, like some jewels, like semi-precious stones. Alauddin Khalji said that the state would monopolize that. How? By paying money as an advance to the Multani merchants. Alauddin Khalji would invest money to the Multani merchants and tell these merchants that they have to buy this commodity, sell only to the state. Sell only to the state. State then would be the source of supply to the markets. Implementation. Strict regulations was imposed. Each and every commodity's prices were fixed. Rice, wheat, barley, horse, slave, everybody, from smallest needle to the biggest horse. Barani said. Jiyauddin Barani mentions that Alauddin Khalji fixed the price from the smallest needle to the biggest horse. Jiyauddin Barani, abdi solra, on Alauddin Khalji paat. Okay? All this were put in place. Next, Alauddin Khalji put strict regulations for any hoarding, anybody cheating in the market, severely punished. They are all severely punished. He appointed an officer who is called Shana. S-H-A-H-N-A. Shana hi Mandi. Officer pere. Mandi na market nartho. Shana na officer nartho. Shana hi Mandi. Officer was appointed. You got this point? So all. Sir, what is the impact, sir? Impact is what? Very simple. Definitely, as long as Alauddin Khalji was alive, it worked successfully. Worked successfully. It should have benefited the larger sections of the people, so there was no revolt and rebellion. He kept military under strong means intact. Of Alauddin Khalji, immediately Mubarak Khalji withdrew the measure. So this market reforms of Alauddin Khalji is a great success as long as he lived.